How you going, guys? Curtis from Cutting Edge Engineering. Today's job is going to be part two of our D8 dozer blade repair. If you missed part one where we replaced the mould board, the side cutters and the cheek plates, there'll be a link in the description below. So I've still got lots to do. I still need to fully weld out the corners of the blade, fit the gussets, put on a new wear skin and also change out the hungry board. Before I finish welding out the corners, I do need to flip the blade over, dog the original skin down to the mould board and fully weld that out. Once that's done, we can move on to the next step. Thank you. next thing I need to weld on are the gussets that go under the blade to support the moldboard. But before I can weld those on, I do need to bolt the cutting edges down, and that's to try and eliminate a bit of distortion. Because I will be welding in between every bolt hole, it will pull it out of shape. So by bolting the cutting edges on, that is going to help eliminate that. Also need to mark out the bolt holes for the corner tips. I don't get them drilled because we do sometimes need to make little changes, and if I got them pre-drilled, they might not end up in the right spot. So while the cutting edges are bolted on, I can set where the corner tips are, mark out those holes, and drill them. Thank you. Let's shoot out so quick. Now with all that done, we're going to flip the blade over again so we can finish welding out the corners. So even though I've got layers of weld throughout the entire corner, that's not enough. I still need to do a couple more passes right around the perimeter, and I still need to weld the inside down here. So there is still a lot of work to do in this corner, but I do have extra work that I wasn't planning on doing. Unfortunately, I made the mistake on not checking the drawer, and now I have to deal with the outcome. So this plate here should have been about 50 mil longer, and that would have extended the cheek plate all the way out to the corner tip. So there's no real point to try and cut a piece of plate and put it in there. It is small enough that we can just fill it with weld. Righto guys, so that's that corner completed. It took about 2 hours to fully weld that out, and most of that time was actually spent fixing that mistake. Off camera, I've already gone ahead and done the other side because it was exactly the same. So now with all of that done, we can get on to fitting our gussets and welding them in place. So we've got three different types of gussets. They're all made from 20mm Biz 80 plate. So we've got three gussets for each of the corner sections. We have 14 that support the mold board to the blade, and then we have one for each of these positions. Righto guys, so that was about 2 hours of solid welding. It doesn't look like much, but when you're doing three passes on each side of the gussets, it does add up. So now what I need to do is fit the gussets to the inside of the corner tips. Righto guys, so that is the underside of the blade completed. All the welding is done. There is still some grinding to do, but I'm not going to do that just yet. I'll do that once the entire job is finished. So the next thing I'm going to work on is fitting the new skin. But before I can fit the skin, I do need to gouge off the piece of material that supports the hungry board. Because it is bent, the top of the blade skin will be leaning back a little bit, and I don't want to lock that in the wrong position. So by cutting out that piece of material that's damaged, it will relieve the blade skin and allow everything to sit correctly. So let's get this blade flipped over.
Stay.
Get it. Okay.
So I've gouged off the hungry board support plate. The top of the blade skin did go back into its original position. Now I'm going to go around to the front of the blade and use the gouger to clean off any of the high spots. Come in with a 9-inch grinder, get all that nice and flat, and then it will be ready to fit the new skin. Righto, so that's our skin in place, but we still have a lot more work to do. I still need to weld the skin in, fit and weld in the side skins, fit and weld in the support plate for the hungry board, finish welding the cheek plates and a few other things. But unfortunately, Karen has run out of time with editing, so you just have to stay tuned for part 3. Thanks for watching.
Good start.
So I've got the skin welded onto the mold board. What I'm going to do now... Oh, wait. Righto, so we've got the skin welded. Fucking Jesus. Righto, so I've got the skin welded.
Is your arm bleeding? Yes.
Was. Notice all of these handles are bent.
Well, no, can't really tell.
You wait till I try to put them on. This is a drill that took a big fall.
Okay.
See how bent it is?
Could you not make new ones?
Oh, that's my list of shit to do.
Jesus Christ! What happened?
Right.
Right,
ready?
Yep.
Now I'm going to go around the front of the blade, clean up all of the...
Use words like and.
Now I'm going to go around to the front of the blade and grot... And now I'm going to go down... Oh, fuck. Now I'm going to go around to the front of the blade and use our gouge... Oh, fuck! Ready?
Yeah!
Righto, guys, so that's our skin in place, but we still have... So I need to weld the skin in, fit and weld in the side plate. So I need to weld the skin in, fit and weld out the,
How's the serenity?